ladies and gentlemen, making his first appearance since March 6th, 2017. Sheldon Mix on the hill for St. Cloud State, the 6'4", 210-pound redshirt junior lefty from Shakopee, Minnesota. The two-time All-American left-handed pitcher from 2015, where he was the NSIC Freshman of the Year, an All-American, an All-Region pick, an all-term. Sheldon gets his sign from Bo and the first pitch. Strike one on the outside corner. The 0-1 here from the Huskies' former ace. Strike two on the outside corner. And sit down, strike three swinging. Sheldon Mix gets the first man he faces in over a year.
Yeah, so I went on a few visits to a few different colleges, and St. Cloud being one of them. I got on campus. I didn't know what to think. I had a previous teammate here, Zach Hoffman. And so he, you know, I'd heard stories about what it was like and stuff like that, but I didn't really know what to expect of the campus or the coach or anybody else. Got here and it just felt comfortable. It felt like I was kind of home, away from home in a way. And from then, you know, it just kind of clicked for me to accept a spot on the team here.
St. Cloud State Baseball welcomed true freshman Sheldon Mix to their starting rotation in 2015. On a team loaded with veteran presence, the young left-hander deftly handled the pressure of a large role.
I played with one of his former teammates, Zach Hoffman at Shakopee, and he was one of my good buddies, and he came in with me. And when he said that we were getting this 6'3" big lefty, I kind of had full expectations. He's going to be probably throwing about 88, 89. He's like, yeah, this kid, I can't even explain him. He's extremely talented, gifted. And I was like, okay, I can't wait to see him. So I get to meet him. He's got the size. Everything's there. I'm sitting there. I'm like, all right, I'm excited to see him throw now. Next thing I know, it's 79 to 81. And I'm sitting here, I'm like, holy crap. Like, I did not see that coming. But then I got in the batter's box against him. And I'm like, now I can see what people are talking about. He doesn't miss spots. He is confident every pitch. I don't know what's coming, because he'll throw any pitch in any situation. And he's not afraid to do it. And even as a freshman, when he came in, same way. Especially as a freshman, you don't really get that very often. Somebody that is that comfortable and that confident and that focused like that. So it was pretty unbelievable to see, to be honest.
You know, it was an eye opener. You know, you come in as a little freshman, and you know, it's a senior heavy group or upperclassman heavy group, and you know, these guys are bigger, faster, stronger than you are, and you kind of see that and notice that, and you know, it's a little tough being away from home for the first time and getting to know new people, but it was a great group of guys to come in with, and they made everybody feel at home, and they made the transition really easy for all of us. You know, I just remember kind of going to first day of practice and forgetting my socks, my long black socks, and I'm wearing, you know, white ankle socks with cleats, and I'm thinking, oh man, this is how this is going to go, and you know, hoping I don't get noticed by all the upperclassmen.
Sheldon Mix also made a close friend and teammate, Zach Sigelko, his dorm roommate and eventual housemate throughout their college careers.
Yeah, we're both pretty creative in wasting our time or spending time, especially in the dorms. I think it was right around the time of my birthday, because I'm on the 20th, and Sheldon's 4 days older than me. And his parents were very kind and sent us a care package, you know, a pretty common freshman year and stuff. And in that, there was two paddles and a ball, and these two plastic things. And so we started playing, you know, it's kind of like a version of fungo golf. We called it dorm golf, though. And we would play for hours on end and make up all these crazy rules. And got other people in the dorm involved and stuff. So I think probably right around, you know, obviously moving in and getting together and playing some dorm golf, we learned that we were going to click.
Mix dominated the competition in 2015, earning Northern Sun Intercollegiate Conference Freshman of the Year, First Team All-Conference, and First Team All-Central Region honors. The Southpaw charted a 10-2 record over 16 appearances and 12 starts, holding a sparkling 1.15 earned run average across 86 innings. Opposing batters managed a meager 196 batting average against Mix. He also tossed 7 complete games with 4 shutouts on his way to the first All-American nod of his collegiate career. As the 2015 NCAA Central Region Tournament began, with a trip to the College World Series in the Husky sights, Sheldon Mix met the first major challenge of his collegiate career. St. Cloud State discovered a new rival in Henderson State, as the Reddies dumped the Huskies twice in the tournament. He received a loss in both games. The thought of Henderson State doesn't exactly bring good memories to Sheldon.
8 seed coming in and beating a number 1 seed in the regional game 1. You know, it wasn't one of my best starts. Probably one of the most memorable, for sure. You know, I'll never forget that loss in the first game, and the feeling in the dugout and kind of the feeling during the game as things were happening. It was tough because, you know, all year we had been successful and we didn't really know how to fail, if that's the right word. After that started with Henderson, you know, I really didn't care about too much after that. You know, it was an honor to be awarded that, and you know, you respect it, and you know, you're thankful for it. But I would trade that in for a rerun at Henderson State 5 years ago in a heartbeat.
It was unbelievable. I don't know how that even could happen. As soon as Sheldon came in, he was still focused. He was ready to go, but that came down to we just didn't play our game. And that's pretty regrettable, to be honest. Honestly, I think he still beats himself up to this day about that one. He was devastated, and we were devastated as well.
Once the Husky season came to a close at the hands of Henderson State, Mix and fellow All-American teammate Reese Gregory joined the St. Cloud Rocks. In 13 appearances and 8 starts with the Rocks, Mix went 5-1 with a 2.74 ERA over 49 and a third innings. His summer success continued into a dominant sophomore debut, striking out a career-high 12 against Central Region rival Central Missouri.
Yeah, this is one of the coolest games I've pitched in, you know, being at Minute Maid Stadium in Houston against a regional opponent who was, you know, pretty highly ranked at the time, and it was a big game for us.
Just like his freshman season, Mix earned a truckload of accolades after going 8-3 with a 1.96 ERA. Unfortunately, another early regional tournament exit, this time to Emporia State, befell the Huskies in 2016.
Kind of harder that year because we had a pretty big, you know, senior class again. So it was another disappointing feeling at the end of the year. I remember, you know, talking to Kyle Leeser, you know, and watching him play all year and be a leader for us was impressive, and he took control of the game in the regional, you know, and stepped up and kind of got in people's faces a little bit and you know, had that grit and a little bit of a chip on his shoulder to prove that we could do it. You know, and that was a good leader to kind of do that. He was quiet most of the time throughout the year. So for him to step up and be vocal, be the vocal leader, was a difference, and kind of hammered home the importance of this regional and the importance of every game.
As his true junior 2017 season approached, expectations were high. Leading a team full of young talent and newcomers, Mix found a familiar face as his new pitching coach, Brett DeGagne, a Sauk Rapids native who had met Sheldon when the two were pitchers on the 2015 St. Cloud Rocks staff.
Sheldon was a guy that just really gravitated to me right away, and I gravitated to him too. I mean, obviously he was a really good pitcher, but he was a really good person, and he was really striving for something else in his career. He wasn't satisfied with his freshman year that he had, which was obviously incredible, but he wanted more, and him and I, every day we took part in our routine together. He kind of hopped in with me when we do our running and throwing and things of that nature, and we spent 2-3 hours a day together just getting our work in and before games, and that obviously, you know, flourished our relationship because of it.
In fact, Sheldon was the first call DeGagne made when considering the job.
Yeah, honestly, he was probably the first guy that I really reached out to. I think there was 8 guys that I had formerly either played with or coached that were on that roster at the time, but Sheldon was like the first person I reached out to just because I knew his opinion held a lot of weight compared to others, and I wanted to get his take on it. And he was super supportive of it and really excited about it, and I was obviously as well, so I'm glad it got to materialize.
Heading into his junior year, gaining velocity was a focus in hopes of a potential professional career.
You know, I wanted to, I guess the priority was to gain velocity, you know, and continue being successful, continue working hard, and then continue, you know, just helping the team as much as I could, you know, and that was kind of primarily it. Obviously, I knew that, you know, it was the junior year and the draft year or whatever, and, you know, I wanted to give myself the best chance of going somewhere. You know, the hopes weren't too high, but, you know, if I could help myself by gaining 3 or 4, or, you know, even a couple miles an hour, then, you know, I'll do that, and in turn, it'll hopefully improve my outcome on the field as well. So it's kind of a dual process there.
Sheldon and I really kind of, we wanted to gain velocity. That was his biggest thing. He had kind of been stagnant for a couple of years. And the stuff was there, the numbers were there, and it was, you know, a bona fide, like really, really, really good college pitcher. But he wanted more, like he did after his freshman year, but he wanted more. He wanted to gain velocity. He wanted a chance at playing professionally. And so we sold out for that to an extent. We wanted to go all in on some things, and he gave me the keys to the car and to try to help him on that. And we did some, you know, obviously we implemented some weighted balls, some bands, some different arm care routines and things of that nature to help with his arm velocity, but also some movement stuff with some mound deficiencies that he had. And we really tried to gain that velo to go with all the other intangibles that he had on the mound as well.
Mix made his first career opening day start in 2017 against Concordia St. Paul. His second start of the season came in Tucson, Arizona against Southwest Minnesota State. Midway through the second inning, the two-time All-American threw a pitch that would drastically alter the course of his playing career.
Yeah, you know, I can't even tell you the first, you know, couple batters or whatever it was. The only thing I really remember is throwing out of the stretch and throwing a curveball about, you know, 50 feet. Metzger looking at me and, you know, kind of knew that something was wrong. And you know, I felt a little pop in my elbow, a little pain, and kind of took a second to throw the next pitch. And usually I'm a pretty high tempo guy, just get on the mound and throw. And I kind of took a second in between pitches. And I think he kind of knew what was going on. Ended up throwing, I think it was like 8 or so more pitches, and ended up getting out of the inning. And basically pulled myself from the game.
I remember the pitch. It was a pitch that didn't look right. Sheldon's got about the cleanest motion you can about ask for, and something didn't quite look right. Kind of gave an arm shake, threw another pitch. He shook off a fastball to go to the breaking ball because he knew he didn't have it, and when he did that, that's when I knew something wasn't right. Went out and tried to talk to him. And he wanted to finish the inning. He finished the inning, gets in, and we obviously knew something wasn't right. We got checked on, and we decided to yank him from the game as a whole. But that pitch was pretty eerie for me. I still look back on it, and it kind of gives me a really sick stomach feeling. And unfortunately, it had to happen, and you know, he's better for it now.
After the team returned to Minnesota, Sheldon underwent an MRI on his elbow. The results were extremely disappointing.
UCL, or the ulnar collateral ligament, is a triangular-shaped ligament on the inside of your elbow. It connects your ulna to the humerus and prevents the elbow from a valgus force, or inward bending of the elbow.
I felt like, you know, a week. It was only like 2-3 days. We were in Sioux Falls, at Augustana's home field, and I was shagging home run balls because I couldn't throw or anything, so I was just, you know, out in turfs, and our trainer came out and basically said that she had gotten results and told me my UCL was partially torn, and so I didn't really know what to think. You know, I was disappointed and didn't know what to expect from you know, all this information being thrown at me, and didn't know my, or the next step in the process and all that stuff. But, you know, it was game day, so nothing I could really do about it then and there. And so we just kind of had to live with it for a few more days.
A month after his first career opening day start, Sheldon was faced with the reality of Tommy John surgery.
So the first Tommy John surgery was performed in 1974 by Dr. Frank Jobe. And what he did was they drilled small holes in the humerus and the ulna, and then they took the tendon from Tommy John's palmaris longus tendon, and they weaved a figure eight to connect those two bones again to recreate that ligament. But because it's tendon tissue, it can take a long time for the body to remodel that into ligament tissue again.
That was about May that year, I think. And, you know, I had met with Dr. Buss a few times, and we had tried rehab. We had tried a few other things to try and get it to stop hurting and you know, eliminate the possibility of surgery. And after all those things failed, I had another meeting with him, and he basically said, this is your option. You either have a kind of shortened recovery time with a collagen mesh that they overlay on the UCL, or you get the full, you know, Tommy John. I decided to go with the Tommy John, just due to the fact that the other surgery was uncertain, and they had some success with it, but I wanted the safer route just as a precautionary measure.
Staring at a potential 15-month recovery time, Mix managed to return in a little under 14 months.
Honestly, I think like what helped him get through it was the kind of person that he is. I mean, his parents are both incredible people, and they've, you know, guided him to be the person that he is. And I think he's not an excuse kind of person. He doesn't want excuses. He doesn't want people to feel sorry for him. He's just going to show up every day and get his work in and be a good teammate and be a good person and, you know, obviously take care of his incredible amount of schoolwork that he had, and obviously with the major that he's about to finish. And, you know, just the kind of kid he is. I mean, he didn't take any time to feel sorry for himself, and he didn't want anybody to feel that way for him, and he was just going to go about it, and he knew, like, he was going to make it back. He knew it was just a matter of time before he got back on the mound, and longer road than all of us wanted, but at the end of the day, like, he knew what he was getting himself into, and he embraced it and just attacked every day like it was a new day.
You could tell that he was in some pain and maybe a little uncertain on obviously the situation. He's a guy who's always in control, always is very accountable and knows all of his actions, and with that is his training. He trusts his training, and so when that happened, I just don't think that he was completely certain of what was going on, because, you know, you have the training staff and everybody not wanting to assume the worst or anything, but he was smart. I mean, he didn't do anything that would You know, he didn't like have this tough guy mentality. Oh, I'm gonna throw through it even though it hurts, you know, a couple of days after and stuff. He was smart and monitored it, and you know, we were always hoping for the best and everything. But it's scary, you know. I mean, the rest of us were, you know, scared for him and stuff. But he was calm, cool, and collected per usual. But there's one thing that didn't change. It was the way he supported the team. I mean, he didn't ever get bitter or get down at anybody or anything, or never had like the poor me mentality. He stuck to the grindstone, and I don't know, he's always been a great teammate, and that showed, especially early in his recovery stages.
Everyone said that he never really lost any of his drive. Like, the entire time he was still trying to run, he was still trying to stay in shape and stay ready to go, even though he couldn't do much with his arm. So it was pretty great to hear that. Kept in contact with his parents too. They're great people. Like, his whole family is fantastic, and they're a great support system as well.
It was tough. You know, again, the mental side of the game comes in. You know, and you go to the field and you're not really locked in. You know, it may seem like it, but your head's somewhere else, and you want to play, and you see all your brothers basically being successful, and you want to be a part of that success and help out as much as you can. It was tough. It was mentally draining. You know, and the support was there. You know, I had 35 guys on the team that were pulling for me. My parents, my friends. You know, it was a big support group, but it's still very, very mentally draining.
Mix made his return to the pitching staff in 2018 as the Huskies' closer. DeGagne remembers sending his All-American to the bullpen for the first time in over a year during a weekend series at Bemidji State.
That was pretty cool. He smiled like it was the first time he was ever getting his name called in the college game, and everything kind of paid off that day. Everything kind of, like, it was worth it at that point for him. I think being able to get back on the mound, get back to doing what he loves and what he's so incredibly successful at, I think was a really big moment for him to be able to just embrace that moment and really, like, soak it in. I think, like, I noticed a couple times when he was warming up, I looked down at the bullpen and he's, like, just kind of looking around. He wasn't necessarily, like, too intent on throwing his warm-up pitches. He was more soaking it in and just taking in the moment that he was about to embrace.
Sheldon didn't allow a run in four appearances as a reliever. However, the Huskies' season ended once again at the Central Region Tournament, and sights turned to a highly promising 2019 campaign. Mix would lead a pitching staff holding four other All-Americans. He'd be doing so while returning to the starting rotation for the first time since his torn UCL. He admits that he was nervous entering the year.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, it was a small sample size coming back, and it wasn't like I had a lot riding on a few of those appearances. It was more of a bullpen and a yes, I can still throw in a game kind of scenario. This coming back and being a starter, it made it real. You know, you kind of get those butterflies again, and you get, you know, all your teammates relying on you a little bit more. So it was a little bit nerve-wracking. You know, you stand on the mound for the first time starting a game, and you're like, all right, well, here we go. What's going to happen?
Mick's redshirt senior campaign was also marked by the addition of a new catcher, Division I transfer Torin Shahidi.
I didn't know who he was. St. Cloud State had some former All-Americans, had some guys on the team that were some really good players. I see this guy, I'm like, this guy has to be 88, 91, just big time righty. Then I kind of just, someone says who he is, like, yeah, he's a two-time All-American, he's a lefty, and he throws 78 to 81 on a good day. And I'm sitting there, I'm like, how is this guy an All-American? This guy's 78 to 81, guys just don't tee off on him. Then I caught his first pen, and then I kind of figured out, like, ah, that is why no one hits him, because nothing is straight, nothing is missed on a location.
Sheldon made his return to the starting rotation in Game 3 of St. Cloud State's trip to the Houston Winter Invitational on February 3rd of 2019.
down at Minute Maid, when it was his day to pitch, it was just a total like flip of the switch on who he was. It wasn't like he's normally a really, really, but that day he's right there. He's ready to go. We're out playing catch. I'm like, this guy's, because I've never seen him ready to go. I was like, wow, this guy's really ready to go. And then in his bullpen at Minute Maid, kind of next to the Crawford boxes, I don't think he missed a spot. He throws about 25, 30 warm-up. I don't think he missed. And I'm like, what is this guy's deal? And then we get out there, and he doesn't miss a spot. Every pitch he dotted, we dotted it. We started using the big breaking ball a little bit this year that he said he hasn't used a ton. That was really, really effective because no one knew he had it.
All right, fellas, coming off a 3-0 weekend here in Houston. What do you got to say about today's performance against Central Missouri?
I mean, Meyer, what a leader. Unbelievable. I mean, you could go 1 through 9 in our order, and even into the bench, the bullpen. It was an unbelievable weekend. Not much else I can say, I guess.
Yeah. Starting all weekend, the starters went deep. They went deep enough, and we were able to use starters or our top relievers the entire weekend. Shelly got his first win today in, 2 years?
It's been a while.
We're jacked up about that.
Mark, can we talk a little bit about the return of Sheldon Mix to the rotation? So grinding his butt off in the classroom, the weight room, and everything else off the field to get to this point. Can we talk a little bit about that as a fellow fifth-year senior?
Well, it's very exciting to see. Obviously, we came in together, and when a guy goes down and injures, that's not something you want to see. But when you come back and have an outing like that against a team like that, that's unbelievable for him, especially a guy who works as hard as he does, because it just pays off in the end, and you come back from a freak injury, and we're rolling. Huskies are rolling.
All right, enjoy this one, fellas. Good luck.
Thanks, Zach.
After throwing 6 strong innings of 2-run baseball, striking out 5, the 2-time All-American walked off the mound with a sigh of relief.
It was a relief. I'm gonna be honest. It was a relief. It was a great feeling to give our team a chance to win a regional game, an important regional game. I was happy. I wasn't satisfied. It was only the third game of the year, and the ultimate goal is not to win the third game of the year, it's to win the last game of the year. It was a good step toward the right direction, and a step toward being a part of something that is hopefully going to be great.
Through his first 11 outings of 2019, the 2-time All-American holds a 7-2 record and a 3.20 ERA across 59 innings. Mix has struck out 68 and walked just 7, holding opponents to a .613 on-base plus slugging. He looks like he's back to vintage Sheldon Mix form.
Actually, he's right there. From what I've seen so far, I've seen him throw once live because haven't had a lot of home games. But from what I've seen, based on stats, based on what I've heard around everybody, it's like it's the same old Sheldon again. He's really back, and that's absolutely unbelievable to me.
Sheldon Mix is back.
With the postseason looming, Sheldon Mix will front the playoff rotation for a third and final time in his collegiate career. His teammates believe that he's still capable of taking this staff to the biggest stage in college baseball.
Oh, absolutely. It starts with that senior leadership, and obviously having the support of your teammates is huge, and being the way he is, you know, a fifth-year guy now. Everybody's got his back, and he's got ours, and it starts with those captains, too, and the way they lead. I mean, I think the most important thing as a leader is to have a consistent and loyal following, and they've garnered that, and I think that's the highest compliment you can receive as a leader is a bunch of guys who are willing to go in with you and, you know, follow your vision and follow what you're trying to demonstrate. So absolutely, he's capable of that.
He leads by example. He is taking classes that I can't even think of ever even stepping in that room. my course schedule and his course schedule is a little different. It's he is incredibly organized. Really, he has his time managed really well. He tells the younger guys what's expected, and then he shows them what's expected. He has fun coming to the field. Sometimes he probably doesn't feel the greatest because coming off of surgery, I know what it's like. He knows what it's like. Sometimes it's tough, but that guy, he sets an example of, I'm here to do my job and win games. It's not about me. It's about the team, and he is he's a really good leader. I talk to him, and it's yes, no, you got to do this shit, get it together, be it's awesome to have people like him around that understand the game at that high of a level, and truly he cares about his teammates. Sometimes he might get on some other ones, but it's because he wants to win and he cares, that he understands what our jobs are as players to get it done. He's a great teammate, and I'm really, really lucky to have him as my teammate.
As the Huskies barrel their way to another chance at the program's first College World Series appearance, Sheldon looks back at his injury as something that, believe it or not, had to happen.
Why do you think your UCL popped?
I think it was to be with all the guys that I came in with. It's being the only one left that didn't redshirt that freshman year when we all came in. It was a big class. I think that was probably the main reason, was to be with all those guys fifth year, and make something special of the last year that we got.
You see, I wanted to tear to be with those
guys? Yeah, absolutely.
Now pitching for your Huskies, a senior number 16, Sheldon Mix.
1-2 pitches swung on and missed by Olsen. Another strikeout for Sheldon Mix. There's two down in the third. They have been anything but vulnerable so far. 1-2 pitch swung on and missed by Suits. Another strikeout by Sheldon Mix. 2-2 the count from Mix. Swung on and missed. Metzger holds on, and another strikeout by Sheldon Mix. Two down here in the fourth. 2-2 pitch from Mix. Swung on and missed. Strike three. That's number six for the sophomore. 2-2 pitch from Sheldon Mix. Swung on and missed. Strikeout number seven. Seven strikeouts for Sheldon Mix on the day. Two down here in the bottom of the fifth. Count is full from Sheldon Mix. Swung on and missed. Strikes out the side. His eighth strikeout of the game.
Sit down. Strike three swinging. Sheldon Mix gets the first man he faces in over a year. Caleb Carlson out on a swinging strikeout. Welcome back, Sheldon Mix.
0-2 from the St. Cloud State southpaw.
Sit down. He gets Litchie on the cutter. Two strikeouts in Sheldon's first appearance since March 6th of last year. Sit down. Ball game. Sheldon Mix finishes off Central Oklahoma. St. Cloud State gets the victory.
I'm Sheldon Mix, senior pitcher for the Huskies, and this is the KVSC Sports Stream.